You know, I figured I was gonna be in for a rough time watching Nickelodeon's Pinky Malinky when some people told me that they couldn't finish watching it after the first episode. That just kinda set off some red flags. But I remained optimistic until the start of the first episode. That was when I realized this series was gonna hurt when I was introduced to this.
One more time. Okay, one more. Okay, one more time.
That scene alone just told me you're gonna be very, very annoyed. This show is the epitome of desperation. They do whatever to get some sort of laugh out of you without really thinking about the jokes first. Thankfully, it's not the most painful, but it's still a pinch of annoyance. The show was made by Nickelodeon and was put on hold for years until they finally got smart and put it on Netflix. To me, I was thinking, holy crap, they're learning! Until I actually watched it and thought this should have been done with another show like Harvey Beaks or Welcome to the Wayne. They had the right idea with this, but it should have been done with a more deserving show. It's created by Rick Ashbjorn or Bjorn or some asinine way to pronounce that, and Chris Garbutt. The latter was a writer for Amazing World of Gumball and a storyboard artist for Robot Boy and Fairly Odd Parents, which explains some of the vibes of Gumball you get. The premise is a reality show about this hot dog that lives in the human world, which fits into Nickelodeon's repertoire of odd, but it's pretty unnecessary considering the main character being a hot dog doesn't really affect his life in any way. You could have him be a normal human and the show wouldn't be changed by it. Nobody questions the fact that he's a hot dog, so he just blends in naturally, which hurts the idea. It's not like Cat Dog, where the idea of them being fused actually affects how they live. Here, the main character is just fine and lives a normal life like everybody else. The show also plays like a reality TV show with the most annoying aspects, but now in animation, so it's more emphasized in how annoying it can get. Honestly, this show is pretty much a mess. Like, it just misses a good chunk of focus as to what needs to be accomplished and what it wants to do, honestly.
What?
The characters can range from okay to irksome. Your mileage may vary. You have Pinky and his friends Bab Butman.
Oh, Lord.
And JJ Jameson, who has a crush on Pinky's mom.
Okay.
Who are being filmed doing stupid crap all over their hometown. Imagine Jake Paul or every vlog YouTuber who feels the need to record themselves doing the most mundane shit or annoying shit, and that's basically Pinky and his friends. They do wear on your nerves pretty fast. There's not much to distinguish between them other than design and some weird desires they have. There are other characters like Pinky's mom, who's basically a fitness freak. She's more downplayed and probably the only one who doesn't irk you with her antics. She plays the role of a mother pretty well. You can even enjoy how she interacts with Pinky. You also have Pinky's dad, who's paranoid of technology. He has moments of just being pretty stupid because of his fears, but you at least see he really cares for his family. That's honestly the one good thing I can enjoy from the characters, and that's Pinky's family dynamic. Everybody else is just not that interesting.
Work it, work hard, working out, together we shall work it. Work hard, working out, together. Yeah, work out, work out, work out together. Teamwork is awesome, cause when you work hard as a team, you can make amazing things happen when you dream. Teamwork is awesome, cause when you work hard as a team, you can make amazing things happen when you dream.
The humor is as basic lol random as you can get. Most of the time, it feels like they just throw any joke at the wall and hope it'll get a laugh, like this scene.
Bye, Birdie. I love you.
Little did she know I was a real boy and that I loved her too. But I didn't have the courage to transform in front of her. If this relationship was ever gonna work, I would have to learn to control my bird nature.
Bark, 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 bark. Oh, see! Nom, 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 nom. I love her so much, but I'm so shy about transforming in front of her.
Bird boy, flying this fall.
No joke, that guy doesn't come back into play for that episode. Yet for no reason, they're just like, let's start the episode with him. Most of the episodes start and end with some weird non sequitur that doesn't connect to anything or some half-assed setup for the premise. I just don't understand why with this show at all. You may get a laugh, but I'm doubtful. Well, except for this one scene that got a good chuckle.
Sack and Whack has hated everything I've shown him so far. I don't want to delete my account.
Don't worry, Pinky.
I'm back.
The animation just feels like Dollar Store Season 1 Amazing World of Gumball Scraps. They have parts where the animation changes style for no real discernible reason other than Gumball did it and it got a laugh. That's popular, so we should do it too. They don't understand that Gumball is supposed to be a mix of different styles that come together to make a unique environment, not lol random crap. It's not by any means awful to look at. Some of the backgrounds can be sort of nice, and the characters do have some distinct style to them, but it's still not that interesting to look at, and your mind constantly reminds you of Gumball. They have this camera trick to make it feel more like a reality show by having the camera shake, which is pretty stupid considering that they're constantly cutting to different angles and people, so there's no reason to be holding the camera instead of just putting it on a tripod. It gets pretty obnoxious the first time around.
Wow, I messed up bad.
This show is ultimately just harmless for the most part, but annoying if you don't like lol random humor. The characters are fairly bland and uninteresting. The animation just reeks too much of Gumball, but can have nice backgrounds some of the time. It's not the worst thing you'll see. We honestly been through that already. But it's still not something to put time into. Nickelodeon, you had the right idea by putting the show on Netflix so more people could see it, but you did it with the wrong show. I hope you try this with something more deserving, honestly. But that's just a thought.